2020 was a rough year for many companies and industries, but also some have already rebounded to their pre-pandy prices and even hit all-time highs, while others haven't been so lucky. This video will be recommending two stocks that I think will double in 2021, but I warn you now, this is controversial and not for the faint of heart. If you can't handle a little volatility in the short term, if you're looking for fundamentals and value investing, this might not be the video for you. These might not be the stocks for you. But if you're looking for some real gains in your portfolio, you'll want to check these out. Air Canada is the top Canadian stock that I think will double in 2021. The ticker symbol is AC and they're only available on the Toronto Stock Exchange. The company is Canada's leading airline in terms of volume and passengers carried. I had this video kind of scripted and ready to go in November, but I wasn't able to film and edit and release it. That was when Air Canada was around $17 a share, and I ended up buying around 200 shares. So that would have been a 100% guarantee to double because it would only have to go to $34 a share. But now Air Canada is around $22.87, which means we would need around a $46 share price to hit the 100% mark. I'm not saying it's guaranteed, but I am saying it's likely you'll see huge growth in the stock. I don't think we'll be seeing it return back to its all-time highs in the 50s though. This stock entirely depends on the government and the economy. If the vaccine works and the economy's open back up, the government lets us travel, I do see Air Canada coming back, but this is all dependent on a third wave, fourth wave not happening. Without doing a deep dive of their financials, I'm gonna be going over their Q3 press release and give you a few reasons of why I bought this company back in November. Let's start with the bad. Revenues for Q3 were down 86% compared to Q3 2019, and Air Canada had an operating loss of $785 million versus an operating income of $956 million. Making this even worse, they had cash outflows from operating activities of $286 million, compared to cash generated of $834 million last year. These are horrible numbers for an airline, but given the economic situation, this is expected. Let me move on to the good news or the upside. This is where I believe good planning and management comes in. Current ratio. Current assets are still slightly greater than current liabilities. This means Air Canada can pay all of their current debt, even if they're called or due on demand. It's still a little too close for comfort though. They eliminated 20,000 jobs. This is part of a cost-cutting measure. This sucks, I get it, but it does help keep the company's expenses low for now and keep them afloat. These jobs will come back once the economy is open. The government deems Air Canada too big to fail. I'm not sure if that's a good thing, but it hopefully means they'll continue to get aid and funding from the government, at least in the short term, to help keep all their remaining jobs. Management has deferred or canceled 40% of their new airplane deliveries, since they obviously won't be needed. This frees up more than $3 billion in cash flow over the next 3 years. This piece of the press release really stuck out to me: cost reduction and capital deferral. The capital deferral is a temporary saving, but the cost reductions will be extended to the entire company even after the economy recovers. They won't just start spending again. Once they realize these savings and efficiencies, they'll keep them. Operating expenses decreased by $3 billion compared to last year. They've also retired 79 older planes. This means less maintenance, more savings in the future. These aren't just pandemic savings. Let me know if I'm reading this part incorrectly or if I'm misinterpreting it. Unrestricted liquidity of $8.1 billion. If their net outflows are $300 million, I'm reading this as we have 27 quarters of cash should our operations continue at this level. Let me know if I'm simplifying this too much. If we use their free cash flow, let's round this to 600 million. They have a little over 13 quarters of negative cash flow. Barring any additional setbacks, Air Canada can fund their operations for a few years, but I'm optimistic. I'm hoping everyone can travel safely in 2021 and this stock will get back to its previous levels. I don't see this stock trading in the 50s for a long time, but I do see Air Canada trading in the 40s. The next stock that I believe will double in 2021 is Suncor Energy, ticker symbol SU on the New York Stock Exchange and the Toronto Stock Exchange. Suncor Energy is an energy company that specializes in the production of crude oil from the oil sands in Alberta. They've taken a beating in 2020. In the spring, they were down over 65%. they sustained huge losses and even cut their dividend by 55% in order to save cash. This beat the stock down again as there were signs of a rebound. At the end of the year, the stock is still down 50% from their 2020 highs and still pays a modest dividend yield of 3.84%. Cutting dividends is obviously a bad sign in the short term. Everyone sees a cut in the dividend, they panic sell, causing the stock price to decrease even more. A dividend cut is obviously a bad thing for investors, I believe only in the short term, but it gives companies a chance to reallocate and rebuild their position. It frees up some cash for them to focus on what they need to, which is build a stronger balance sheet and pay down some debt. But I do believe as Suncor's profits come back, if we do open up again, this is all dependent on the government and the economy, their profits will slowly come back. When it does, the dividend payout will slowly increase. With every increase, you'll see a slight bump or maybe a big bump in their share price. The company is doing what they're supposed to, which is conserve cash. But I do believe their old dividend wasn't safe. It was a little too high. But I do believe this new lower dividend, they cut it by 55% for a reason. They can sustain this for a few years. I do believe this new lower dividend is sustainable for at least a few years until we rebound. I'll tell you what, don't just take my word for it. Warren Buffett recently increased his position in Suncor Energy near the end of 2020. He bought an additional 5 million shares for a total of 20 million shares. Yes, he has over $300 million in this one stock and actually owns 1.8% of the entire company. I have yet to invest in Suncor, but if I'm able to free up some cash, it's definitely something I'll be watching and I would like to take a position in. They plan to focus on their balance sheet in 2021, reducing debt, managing cash, even increase shareholder returns via share repurchases. If you're wondering why I didn't recommend the better versions, the Canadian equivalent, like the better versions of Suncor, which are Enbridge and Fortis, it's because I don't see them increasing by 100% this year. They've already recovered. The shares are actually doing really well. I have $20,000 in Enbridge and $10,000 in Fortis, and they've been paying a consistent dividend. Nothing has been cut. Those companies are doing really well. I don't see them doubling, but I am bullish on both of them, hence why they're still in my portfolio. That's it for this video. It's a short one. It's a highly requested video. I'm sorry it's a little later than I anticipated, but better late than never. Thanks for watching. Please give me any recommendations of future videos you'd like, and until then, thanks guys.